Good news! To those who are interested to level up with sheet metal, we will be giving away 5 coupons to access JawMark's carton design using sheet metal with Fusion 360 for free. To join, simply comment down below and say or type in Autodesk Ambassador Hub. Welcome back. In this video, we will now apply joints to assemble our components. Let's inspect our challenge once more. As mentioned before, our matcher will go and mate with our base and then our pin to be inserted. Let's head back to Fusion 360. Notice as I hover over the face of our pin, left click and hold, I can move this. Same with our matcher. So selecting our matcher, with our matcher highlighted, I can left click and hold to move this component. An important best practice is to always remove the degrees of freedom of our parent component. In this assembly, our parent component is our base. To remove its degrees of freedom, meaning it can't be moved anymore, we simply need to head to our target component, selecting our base, right-click, and select ground. Notice the pin icon on our base with our base grounded, so we cannot move this component anymore, unlike our two components. So once more, take note, this is an important best practice on creating Fusion 360 assemblies. Moving forward, let's now apply joints. I'm going to head up and select this icon, joint. Shortcut key is letter J. So selecting this, and whenever this dialog box appears, simply make it a habit to select capture position. On this window, we are prompted to select the joint origin or component reference for our component 1. Notice, as I hover over this face, we are seeing an icon on our cursor that looks like a smiley figure. I call this the component reference. In addition, I want you to take note of the position or orientation of the semicircle inside. For starters, the component reference selected will mate with the other component reference. So in this scenario, our intent is to have our matcher or its bottom face to mate on the surface, on this face of our base. So for us to position this exactly well fitted, I'm going to select this component reference, and for the second target component reference would be the component reference that will be available on this face. So let's now select the component reference of our matcher. Left click. Prompted to select the second component reference for component 2. Hovering over this face, so notice it snaps. Let's now select this component reference. Left click. So for the motion type, the appropriate type for this is rigid. In the following monthly challenges, we will discover the rest of this motion types. So for now, let's select rigid. In addition, I can animate this to see its effect. Selecting stop. And finally, hit OK. With our joint in place. Notice on our browser, we have an additional folder containing our joint. And finally, let's grab our pin. So the shortcut for joint is letter J. Let's head over to our pin. Let's select this middle component reference, left click. So if we want our component 2 to be our matcher, definitely we will be selecting the component reference. Let me turn off base. Once more, our target component reference would be this one over here. So same, if we decided to select the or to have base as our component 2, the appropriate component reference would be this one. In addition, notice as I hover over this face, it highlights in white. Same here, same here. And if we hold control while hovering over a specific face, Fusion 360 will be locking us on that face. So for here, I'm going to hold control. Notice as I hover over here, notice I am locked on this face only. So releasing control, I'm now free to move to other faces. Going back, let's now select the component reference for component 2. Let's commit to this one. So I'm going to hold control and select this component reference. Left click. Let's turn on the visibility of matcher and the appropriate motion type to be rigid, and finally hit OK. Congratulations, and that's the basics of creating an assembly with joints. If you had fun with our Fusion 360 monthly challenge, inviting you to join us in Facebook. The name is Autodesk Community Philippines. And finally, join the conversation by signing up in Autodesk Ambassador Hub. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next Fusion 360 monthly challenge.